Hello everyone, Ninetales Commander here with episode 18 of Pokemon Battle Zone. I'm going up against a trainer named Silver. No wait, that's Ricardo. No, that's definitely Silver. Oh whatever, it's my rival. I've got another battle here that is a double battle, which is pretty cool because we had one a couple of episodes ago. So, let's get started. They lead off with Cresselia and Hitmontop. I've got my Jellicent and my trust partner Latios. And of course, they're going to set up Light Screen with Cresselia, and I come to think of it, I don't see Cresselia that much anymore. Back when it first came out, it was ridiculously popular because of how good of a wall it can be, but now I barely see it. I guess times really can change over the course of a few generations. So, I'm going to go for Psychic on the Hitmontop, but of course, since Cresselia set up the Light Screen, it's not going to do that much damage, and he ends up going for the Eject button. That's pretty cool actually, I don't see that very often. And he ends up going out into his Porygon 2. Of course, Ice Beam is going to come out, but it's not going to do that much damage because Cresselia, I end up getting frozen. That's just lovely, isn't it? Yep, that's just lovely. Despite doing not too much damage, I end up getting frozen because hacks. That's a thing. Darn you, balanced gameplay. So, he's going to go for another Ice Beam. Of course, he's going to do a good chunk of damage to my Latios, but not enough to KO it. I'm going to go for Taunt because I don't know what that thing's going to do. It could recover. It could go for Trick Room even. I have no idea what to expect from it, so I'm just going to Taunt just to avoid any trouble. He ends up going for the Thunderbolt, and I get paralyzed. Oh, come on. Jeez, I know I got Toxic off, but at least that's intentional. He's getting status effects alongside with the actual damage. Come on guys, let me do my thing. So anyway, I'm now going to get some poison damage off on Cresselia, and thankfully I do fall out, so thanks game, I'm glad to see you care about me a bit. And of course, because of Light Screen, the Psychic's gonna do very little, and now Ice Beam is gonna KO my Latios, which means now I've gotta bring in something else. So, he's going to go for another Thunderbolt. This won't KO me because Jellicent is a pretty good wall. And I do get off a Toxic, but he avoids it. This game is not loving me today. I really need to get something going here. So, there goes my leftovers recovery. And thank goodness, Paralyze hasn't kicked in yet. And there goes my Toxic damage. Actually getting to be good levels now, which is pretty much the only good thing about Toxic on walls, since you can whittle away their life quite nicely without actually attacking them. He's now going to switch out into his Hitmontop while I bring in my Lucario. Obviously, I'm going to Mega Evolve my Lucario. Intimidate does not matter a slightest because my Lucario is a special attacker, not a physical one. So, there goes my Mega Lucario. And I'm now going to go ahead and use Aura Sphere on the Hitmontop, which definitely is going to get rid of that thing. So, no more worrying about Hitmontop and its shenanigans, even though it didn't do that much to begin with, for the most part. So, there goes Reflect, which I'm again not really bothered about because I am using special attackers. And there goes my Recover. He's now going to get some leftovers recovery, but it doesn't really matter because I have the Toxic support going for me. Obviously, my leftovers is not going to kick in because I'm already at max HP with my Jellicent. He now brings in his Sizzle, which I'm guessing is his Mega Evolution. Yes, it actually is. So, the in comes Mega Sizzle. I'm not particularly worried about it, to be honest, because I'm pretty sure I can still do a good chunk of damage with Aura Sphere on Lucario. But this turn, I'm actually going to go for the Dark Pulse on Cresselia, because I'm pretty sure, combine that with the Toxic damage, it is going to be enough to get rid of the Cresselia, which means I don't have to worry about any more of its shenanigans. And of course, he's going to go for Knock Off, but surprisingly, it does not KO me. But sadly, I end up getting paralyzed, which means my survival was made in vain. Oh dear me, will I actually win this? But fortunately, I do get rid of the Cresselia with the Toxic damage, which I believe means he's only got, oh, he's still got his Porygon 2. But I'm not particularly worried about that because I can easily go after that with the Aura Sphere, and I know he's got Reflect Up and Light Screen, but even so, you know, Mega Sizzle is actually the bigger threat here, so I want to go for Mega Sizzle more so than Porygon 2, since, you know, that is definitely the bigger threat of the two. And he's going to go for Thunderbolt, which definitely will get rid of my Jelly Scent, but I believe I still have one more Pokemon in the boot, and that is actually my Pyroar, which I can use to get rid of Sizzle. But guess what? He surrenders. I don't think surrendering at that point was actually such a wise choice. He may have been able to have still won, since, I don't know, maybe he had something else, but maybe he didn't have the right move to deal with my Pyroar. But whatever. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Peace.